In this module, we'll see how to find the form of a rate law, that is, find the exponents as well as k, the rate constant, using the method of initial rates. So our sample that we're going to use is this reaction here, the reaction of bromate with bromide and hydrogen ion to make bromine, liquid bromine and water. So we know from looking at the reaction, from the chemical equation, that the rate law is going to look like this. The rate is going to be equal to K times the concentration of each of the reactants raised to some power. Our goal is to find X, Y, Z, and K. And we're going to use, okay, so we have some data. We need data to do this, and this table gives us that data. We have four experiments that we can use. So what we do, okay, is we take two sets of data. Let's go back and look at them. And what we're looking for is two sets of data where only one concentration changes. So if we take experiment two and experiment one, the only thing that changes, other than the rate, of course, is the initial concentration of the bromate ion. Everything else is the same over both experiments. So what we do is we plug in to the form of the rate law and take a ratio. So if we take the ratio of rate 2 over rate 1, that gives us this. We plugged this. I'm getting these numbers here from that table that I just showed you. Now notice, okay, this cancels. This cancels. This cancels. These numbers over here, these are the initial rates that from the experiment that we got out of that table there. So once all this stuff cancels, 0.20 to the x over 0.10 to the x ends up being 2 to the x. That's where this came from right here. And dividing these two numbers here, 1.6 times 10 to the minus 3 divided by 8, 0.0 times 10 to the minus 4 gives us 2.0. Okay, solving this equation for x gives us x equals 1. All right, so now we know one of the coefficients in the rate law. We're going to do the same thing for the other two. So here we picked experiment 3 and experiment 2. Let's go back and look at why I picked those. Because in experiment 3 and experiment 2, the only thing that changes in terms of concentrations is the concentration of the bromide ion from 0.1 and 2 to 0.2 in experiment 3. Stays the same here, stays the same here. When we have the initial rates. So, doing the same thing, plugging in rate 3 divided by rate 2 gives us this. The k's cancel. And I didn't put an exponent here because now we know what it is. It's 1, right? So that cancels. This cancels. And we have left 0.2 to the y over 0.1 to the y, which is 2 to the y. And the ratio of the rates gives us 2. So again, solving for y, now we know y is equal to 1. We have 2 of the exponents, going to get the third. Same way. If you look, and I chose experiment 4 and experiment 1 to do this. And again, I did this because the only thing that's changing in between experiment 1 and experiment 4 is the initial concentration of the hydrogen ion. So k's cancel. Again, so we know the first two exponents both 1, so I didn't put letters there. They cancel here, and these are the initial rates from the experiment, the data in the table. So this over this gives us 2 to the z. Dividing the initial rates, we get 4, actually it's 4.0. Solving for z, we get z is equal to 2. Now we know all three exponents. So the form of the rate law looks like this. Rate is equal to the rate constant k times the concentration of bromate to the first power, bromine to the first power, and hydrogen ion squared. Now we're going to find k, the rate constant. All you have to do to find K, now that we know the form of the rate law, is pick any of the experiments. Plug in the concentrations, plug in the rate. So I picked experiment 4, where the rate was 3.2 times 10 to the minus 3 moles per liter second. And plug is equal to K, concentration of bromate to the first, bromide to the first, hydrogen ion to the second. If I multiply this out and solve for K, so I'm dividing both sides by everything in here. All of this goes down here. Okay, multiply it out. Notice the units. Moles times moles times moles squared is moles to the fourth. Liters times liters times liters squared is liters to the fourth. Dividing out, ends up this is equal to 8.0, and the units here, check it out, okay? Make sure you get the same thing as liters cubed for moles cubed seconds. That's K, that's rate constant. Now we're done.